again with another video, and before we get started, a quick word from one of our sponsors.
It's me, the Truckin' Redneck Cop, here to tell you an important message before we continue the video. Make sure to like and subscribe and turn on notifications if you like this content. Anyway, that's all I have to say. Now, I must get back to my police work.
Who left that there? Thank you, the Drunken Redneck Cop. Now, the game we're reviewing today is GoldenEye 007 for the Wii. Wow, this must be an amazing game. Probably the best way to experience GoldenEye. And it's a remaster of the original N64 version. Maybe this is what we've been looking for. This might be the way to experience GoldenEye. It even has a 9 out of 10 rating by... I hope that showed you how bad of a company IGN is on reviewing video games, because they are that bad. But anyways, now that we got that out of the way, let's play GoldenEye.
The game was originally developed by the company Activision, you know, the creator of the Call of Duty games, and was originally published in 2010 on the Wii. Gameplay, it's actually really not that bad. I could dig this control setup any day. You use the Wii controller to point around and move the camera. That's fine. You use the Z button to aim, and you use the B button to shoot. You use the C button to crouch, and you use the nunchuck to move around. Not a bad control setup. I really like it. But at the end of the day, this really feels like Call of Duty to me. I mean, just think of it. It's made by Activision, and it was really just a cash grab for GoldenEye. I did not really have the same GoldenEye experience when I was playing this game, and therefore, it's not the best remake I have played of this game. Textures are really good. I mean, I wasn't expecting a lot since it's a Wii game. The storyline is the same as the GoldenEye movie, except the original actors replaced with Daniel Craig, you know, the new James Bond actor that's going to be in the more recent James Bond movie. but overall, not a bad game. Do I praise it? No. Like I said, it's really all it really did was improve the textures, has the same exact map design, and overall, just pretty much not the best ripoff of Call of Duty. Like, no, seriously, I did not like the fact that they did that, and Activision just did this just for a cash grab. Speaking of gameplay, there is some serious issues with the Remote when it comes to hand-to-hand combat. So, well, no, not hand-to-hand combat, when, like, shooting in the game. Now, there's, like, a boundary for the Wii Remote that if you go too far off the screen, this stupid red circle just locks you in the middle of the screen and just messes up your whole game. I hate it. Why did they have to put it? It just ruins the whole game for me. And also, multiplayer's gone.
Which is surprising, because Call of Duty Black Ops for the Wii is still active in 2019. Look it up, that's not a lie. It's not a lie, you can look that up. But anyways, that's my in-depth review on the game. Is it the best way to play GoldenEye? No. You're better off playing the GoldenEye 64 emulator that you don't have to even buy or download. Just type in a link and you're there. You're playing GoldenEye with a mouse and keyboard at 60 FPS, and it's like literally the best way to play GoldenEye 64. Go look at my GoldenEye 64 video where I talk in depth about it. But anyways, playing this game, it actually even makes the N64 version better than this. That is just sad. It literally took a step backwards from what we wanted. And I bet you my review is more accurate than IGN's review, because literally they have a piece of paper that their boss wrote and they have to read off it. Yeah, not an accurate review. Well, anyways, that's all I have to say, guys. I'll see you in the next video, and make sure to like and subscribe if you like this content. And as always, this is Nathan Drake, signing out.
I've spent a lifetime running, and I always